In this video, we're going to take a look at how to create numbers and date sequences using Microsoft Excel. So the first thing we are looking at is the blank Excel spreadsheet, and I'm going to type in some numbers. 1, 2, and 3. And the easiest thing to do is sometimes you need to do that. You may need to replicate this number. So I need to select this set of numbers, and you see this black rectangle at the bottom, and you just copy it and drag it here, and it just continues replicating the sequence. So it keeps 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and up to 24, or you can continue doing that. So that's pretty useful when you, for example, have a list of tasks and you need to assign unique ID for this task real quick. That works very well. The alternative is when you can just have the number 1, right, and you can copy this number, Control C, and you can also paste it through all the rows, but it's only going to be number 1, right? It's the same number, versus what we just did here is we did a sequence which is sequentially increments number by 1. The trick here is that doesn't have to be incrementing by 1, could be incrementing by 5, for example. So for example, you have 1 and then 5, and then so we are adding 4, right? The next one in sequence would be 9, right? And we copy the sequence and we extend it, and it automatically increases the numbers by 4, right? So 1 plus 4 is 5, plus 4 is 9, and etc., etc., etc. So this is very, very useful. A couple of interesting things here I'd like to show you. One is, for example, if you want to copy things with formatting or with no formatting, for example, you have 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3. Right, and then you're trying to, you have some formatting, maybe the yellow background and bold for these numbers. So what you're trying to do, you're trying to copy these numbers, but you want to do it without formatting. So you extend it, and you see this little box that shows up, and you can choose, you have options. You can just copy cells, fill series, right? That's what we're doing, we called fill series. Then we fill formatting only. So let's try that. And see, it copied the bold and it copied the yellow background, but it didn't copy the numbers. What we can also do is fill without formatting. So what it did is it copied the numbers, but it didn't copy yellow background and the bold. So let's go back real quick, fill formatting only. You don't see the bold, right, because the numbers are empty, but if you type something, it's going to be bold. So this is pretty useful feature as well. And the last thing I wanted to show you is that it's not just applicable to numbers, it's also applicable to dates. So for example, let's do 4/25/2014, right? And then next date would be 4/30/2014, right? So same thing, you select those dates and you can extend the numbers, not the numbers, but the dates in this particular sequence. So you see it's going to increment the dates. So I think it's also pretty useful. Same thing applies with formatting, and there are also some other options. It says fill days, fill weekends, fill months, and fill years only. So sometimes this is not useful though. Sometimes doing numbers is not useful. Why it's not may not be useful. For example, I'll give you a good example. Let's say I'm working on the table, and let's say my table is, let's use a new sheet for that. So let's say my table contains the list of tasks. So for example, I have a list of tasks, which would be sequential list of tasks for construction projects. So the first thing I need to create a blueprint, and then build a basement, right? And I did create a sequence here, and I'm just gonna use a very simple example here. And next one would be build a house. All right, so I'm gonna extend my sequence here, and it's gonna be 3. Now let's say I wanna insert a new task, and you see I have a gap now. So I can type in the a number here, connect plumbing, for example, to my house, but I do have a gap. And this gap is not automatically filled. I'm gonna have to re-extend it. That's my one option. Or what I also can do with the sequence of numbers, I can do manual increments and use formula for that. So for example, I can say this cell 2 is equal cell 1 plus 1, right? And then I can copy this cell and I can paste it, and that makes it a little bit easier, gives me a little bit more control. Please make sure to download the file from this tutorial. Just navigate to www.howtoanalyzedata.net and search for this particular topic that you just listened. And also, please share your feedback. I read all of them and always appreciate it. Just share the honest feedback to help me improve and get better. Thank you very much.